4 o'clock one morning, they wake me from sleeping. I'm lying on the bed, I'm tired, I can't raise my head. He comes and blows in the constant wind. I open to see him. Make y'all in the backseat, dress in her bikini. I don't mind he talking to she, and she talking to he after all. I don't mind he takes her to work every morning in the taxi. I don't mind they seeing each other, and they carry on. But what I can't take is the way that he blows the smoke to go. And I never find a better night in my better year in my Calypso career than in 1949. I've never seen that, man. I tear the tongue to pieces in 1949, man.
What tunes did you sing in 49?
The director of education must go. Lego the dog, Gemma. The waltz in boxes with Barton and Gentle Daniel. The waltz in boxes. Freddie William murder at Vancouver. See next one. The McCarthy case. The commandos strike at dawn, and the magistrate said to bring them and he will take charge of them. I call him a criminal magistrate. I mean, I had this time, you know, police, only police were wrong this time. Only police intent, man. Waiting and the people crowding and coming in, magistrate, all magistrate, everybody coming. The attorney general told me down and called me down there and said, look at this table. Only letters, look at this, and all is on you. I don't know what to do. Yeah, Prince Supiani tell him, you are not a native, you know, you will know nothing about Calypso. I had them to hang, man. Sonny De Silva, Tipper Casket in Sonny Grande. A friend, I had him to say, go mash me in your car. I mean, I was ruthless, man. Ruthless. I seen racial segregation in Bermuda. And you know that gave me a bad time in Demerara. I sang, in the Bahamas and in Bermuda, you have to be careful there with your color. In the Bahamas and in Bermuda, you have to be careful there with your color. You can be Haile Selassie of Ethiopia or Dr. Al Bunch, the Yankee peacemaker. If your color is black, you know you're doomed. And not a hotel on the island rents you a room. Bermuda, oh Lord, if you please, keep Bermuda away from the West Indies. Bermuda, oh Lord, if you please. I'm so glad that she is not in the West Indies. Mr. Hugh Springer, a colored lawyer, was treated worse than a burglar through his color. No accommodation. What an unfortunate situation. Sir Frank McGravid from Demerara suffered the same fate there at Bermuda as the color was black. The chance was doomed, and not a hotel on the island rent them a room. Bermuda, oh Lord, if you please, keep Bermuda away from the West Indies. Bermuda, oh Lord, if you please, I'm so glad that she is not in the West Indies. When Queen Elizabeth landed at Bermuda, they gave an official dinner, a beautiful queen, nice preparation. No colored persons receive invitation. It's undemocratic. You will agree an insult to the colored community. If you're black in Bermuda, it's better you're dead for his hell and damnation for your daily bread. Bermuda, oh Lord, if you please. Thank
you. How would you compare Calypso today with the Calypso in your golden era?
I don't like affinity to do, but I don't think what you sing in today's Calypso. It beat me. I realize that there got to be changes, I realize that modern things have to come true. You can't keep a thing in a vacuum all the time, vacuum. But I believe too that the root of a culture should always be there. And whatever they're singing now, though it might sound all right, peppy and all that, but I don't see. The calypso is too far away from them. Calypso dead already. Finished. I told Karat, and told the man, and he told me that, I said, Kitchener, I had you blaring the flag of the calypso world. And you gone? He said, boy, they don't buy calypso. The people buying something else, and I want money. I had to go and sing boom boom, shwa boom boom, all kind of thing. Dr. Slinger dressed in a costume for me as if he was coming from the sky, some kind of thing. He had on. He watching me, he said, Tiger, you see how Calypso does dress now? I see you, partner. Go ahead. Go ahead. But they never sing a good calypso. And I don't think most of them have heard a good one. So you don't blame them. I don't think so. But they make a mess of it. Now, the one you call party song. Well, they call that party also, party song. I stay about 3 days giving a good look and listen to it. The lyrics are not too far from one another. It's about the same thing. The tune are not moved too far from one another. Same thing. I say, my God, what is it now? Well, why call it calypso? Give it a new tune, give it a new song. But I believe as calypso has been cemented so many years and make root, it would be better to hinge it on to calypso than to open a new avenue and tell that song, you use this song, we're going to break through. I think you'll have more work there. It's better to call it calypso and the thing. Anything right in calypso. But I think it, somebody will bring it back. They lost their road. I came back in calypso when calypso was dead. That's what brings back. I came back in calypso when people were singing la 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 ti ta la 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 ta la 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 ti ta la 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 da 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 la bam bam da la ba da 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 la da 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 la ba ba da bam bam. That's most in tune is going about. Until I come in and then I say, take me, I am feeling lonely. Take me down to Lucy Row and don't let no one know. She said, oh, take me, I am feeling lonely. Take me down to Lucy Row and don't let no one know. She was a girl in society, she never drank dumb either whiskey. I give her a pint of crown, iron beats and she take me down to Lucy Row. She just said it was, take me, I am feeling lonely. Take me down to Lucy Row and don't let no I said, I would like to take you from home and after to see you hungry and roam. When anybody to speak of me, I'd rather leave you home at your family. But she said to take me, I am feeling lonely. Take me down to Lucy Row and don't let me more than know. She said to take me, darling. I am feeling lonely. Take me down to Lucy Row, don't let me more than know. That was the kind of pitch. And a bellis money dookie. My fellas money do accept my congratulations on your bright performance in Great Britain. I say performance money dookie 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 my fellas money dookie. Accept my congratulations on your bright performance in Great Britain.
Any message you want to give to the younger Calypsonians coming up?
Well, you call them Calypsonian. Okay. I believe in the plan. I have done quite a lot for Calypso singing, I think. But my most contribution, I believe, is getting young singers to join the rank that the art may continue to live. One of the last things that happened to me that makes me feel very proud, in 1980 I made a song, an album, and it won a Grammy's award. It is run a Grammy's nomination in America. They send it for me, they send the things for me. They said, as the most authentic album for 1980, was sung by the Tiger. It's placed on the Grammy's award shelf. I said, well, I hasn't done bad after all. I'm going out good. Yes, I'm going out good. Yes, I would like the Calypso to concentrate more on their lyrics. I think they should always get themselves to, in a way, that can give the public a little more entertainment. They have to stop singing one song for a season, or two songs for a season. Make it possible that they can change program. I think it will do quite a lot for the Calypso singers. And the apparel is not the right thing. Tourists will be coming to Trinidad, and when the car is passing on the road, the chauffeur saw a good Calypsonian or the king and tell the tourist, that's the king of Calypso, when he watch him. You can't value him. My grandmother say, you don't know what day you're going to meet your nan and keep out dressed. No? When don't go out dressed, when she meets you, say you're suffering. So I'm asking the young Calypsonian to pull together. And the association they has there may stay together. I was 3-time president of that association. And apparently they appear to do some kind of thing. Yeah? And I wish them good luck. I may not live to see they get the best out of it. But remember that I was in Calypso from 20 cents to 60 cents. Now it is $15 and $20 a week for Calypso. So that a meteoric rise and keep it there and keep it and care it more. You must be paid as a well-known artist. Work for it. Work for it and you will get it. It's there for you. The killing is there. And take it and remember that the Growling Tiger told you so at the end of his time.
Even in and by his passing, his life continues to stay with us in different ways, as a public figure, as a Calypsonian. He has contributed in a way that cannot be measured. As one of those early Calypsonians, he had to suffer a lot. He had to endure ridicule, He had to break the ground. He was one of those who was there from the start and who continued, who never gave up, who had the courage to believe in what he was doing. And though not understanding fully where it would all end, maybe not even foreseeing the kind of era that we now live in, where Calypso is so heralded, where it has found its place. In some sense, there's far to go still, but it is recognized. A Calypsonian is no longer scorned in the way that maybe he was scorned in his early days, where parents wouldn't mind, even if they might not like it too much still, they wouldn't mind to see their sons and daughters singing Calypso. He was one of the early ones who had to carry a cross in a very real way. And yet, he must have been a very inspired man, for his art, his talent, is something that is rare.
I've known him to be a man that is proud yet humble, quiet yet talkative, a man whose life means much in spite of the fact that he's no longer with us. A life that was lived very quietly, very peaceably, a man who was very generous and benevolent, a man who I believe held the dignity of life in high esteem, a man who was very respectful, a man who even without a word commanded respect from those who were ever in his presence. He left Saparia, I guess, as a young boy and came this way. Was a boxer, but somehow was drawn into the life of Calypso. And by the Calypsos that he sung, he told a story about the right and the wrong of life. The Calypsos he wrote, the life he lived, have given all of us some sense of direction as to what good living is all about. And this man lived a life that was worthy of living. I believe that there is nothing that he has to regret about the life he lived. I'm not saying that he was a perfect man, but all of his goodness overshadowed whatever his wrongs were. And I'm just grateful that you came today to share with us in this our bereavement. I have seen enough debt in, I guess, the past 23 years that I understand that those of us that die in Christ are just asleep. And so in my final statement, I want to take this opportunity to say to all of you that living is one thing, but it's appointed unto man once to die, and after death, the judgment. And so one must be ready for this judgment. And my father, by the religious life he lived, he spent much of his time right here in this sanctuary. Every 12 noon you could find him in here when he was well enough to come this way. I know him to be a praying man, a man who prayed for everybody that he could think of. And I think that he has, above all that he has done in terms of his singing and living, I think this consecrated life that he lived before God should be an example for all of us. That we have a soul to save and a God to serve. I thank you once again, and my family thank all of you for being here.
If you have money to buy in a store, the boss will shake your hands at the door. Call the clerk to take down everything. Whiskey clot, herring and diamond.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, the first official monarch of Trinidad and Tobago, 1939, the Growling Tiger.
A man of money today, people do not care if he have cocoa bay. He can commit murder and get a free and live in the governor's company. But if you are poor, the people tell you shoe and a dog is better than you. If you have money to buy in a store, the boss will shake your hands at the door. Call the clerk to take down everything. Whiskey clot, herring and diamond.
Okay. How would you like?
And they're carrying on.
as a Calypsonian. I would like to remember as a Calypsonian.